Have you ever labeled anyone who has committed rape on her daughter as psychopath? Or have you ever labeled anyone who has committed a very gruesome crime as psychopath? Or else have you ever labeled anyone who is doing a serial killing as psychopath? If you have done so, then this video is for you. Because I am making now a video on psychopath and all the things related to psychopath. That is, who are psychopaths, what are the difference between the psychopath, sociopath, sexual predators, serial killers, and other type of psychopaths. Now, it is really common and it has become a fashion to label anyone who has committed any brutal killing or any brutal crime or a person who is of perverted mind or anything, if a person is doing anything abnormal, then it has become a tendency that to label him as a psychopath. But always remember that every other person who is doing anything which is not normal doesn't mean that that person is psychopath. Psychopath usually live in the society only, between us only. So they may be anyone, because they are the person who are having really good position in the society mostly. They are good looking also, they are friendly also, because they are very manipulative. And they, after living between us only, they used to target people and they used to commit crime. So you have to be very careful and you have to look after everyone's characteristic and then identify whether the person is psychopath or not. Maybe there are some characteristics which could be yours also, but it doesn't mean that you are psychopath. You have to finalize and identify all the characteristics which the psychopath is having, and then only you can label anyone psychopath. So always try to understand, remember, identify, and then label anyone psychopath. Usually people think that psychopaths are very ugly and very dangerous in their looks, like this. But in reality, they are really beautiful and handsome, like this. Psychopathy is a psychological personality disorder, or popularly known as antisocial personality disorder. This is something which is a part of an antisocial personality disorder. There are some more personality disorder, like sociopath also is a part of an antisocial personality disorder. Although this particular term psychopathy has been developed by Checkley in his book Mask of Insanity. Later on, many works has been done on psychopaths, but Dr. Hare and his associate has done an exhaustive research on psychopath, and they have developed, after the research, a psychopathic checklist, which is now a psychopathic checklist revised, which we consider mostly those person who are studying of psychopath as a foundation or a basis to understand the characteristic of psychopaths. So I will be taking the notes or characteristics from psychopathic checklist revised to make you understand who exactly are psychopaths. So let's discuss. The first characteristic of psychopath is lack of remorse or empathy. That means they are not having any guilt of their act. No matter that act could be very brutal or gruesome in nature. It can be identified by many examples of psychopath, like example of Ted Bundy, example of, I think, the Nithari case in with the Suren Kohli and Gracie. There are n number of examples of psychopath who used to commit a crime that is very brutal in nature, and after committing that crime, they are very open to that particular crime and they do not have any remorse, any empathy or any guilt of that particular crime. So this is the first characteristic of psychopath. The second characteristic is shallow emotion. Now, shallow emotion, as the word says, that the person who is not having any sympathy with other person, or the person who is having jealousy, who is having greed or sadistic nature. And if he could see any person in pain, he is not having any tendency of helping them, or he might enjoy that particular thing. That is called a shallow emotion, which is again a characteristic of psychopath. Next characteristic of psychopath is manipulativeness. That means, as I said, that psychopaths are having a very good position in the society. They might be CEO, they might be doctor, engineer, surgeon, professors, lawyers, judges, and even the police officer. So they are very manipulative. Usually what happened, they used to see that who are the person in the society who are loved by others. And they used to imitate that particular personality so that they can target their victim. And if you think and if you desire that the psychopath, that particular person who is psychopath and you doesn't know that he is a psychopath, that that person must be very friendly, he will react or act as a very friendly. If you want him as be an inspiration, he will inspire you. So that is a basic tendency, that they are very manipulative so that they can easily target their victim. Next characteristic is lying. Definitely the person who is very manipulative, he must be a good liar also. They used to lie, and because out of that tendency only, they used to target anyone. The next tendency is, or characteristic is, they are very egocentric. Now if we relate egocentric with psychopath, basically they made their own world in which they think that whatever their perception, their thinking, that is only right. And they used to implement that in a very meticulous manner. They are very intelligent, as I say, as well they are very manipulative also, they are liars also. So definitely they are having ego, and out of that egocentricity they used to commit crime, and for that crime they even frame and develop the crime in a very meticulous manner. So yes, they are egocentric. Next tendency is low frustration tolerance. That means every psychopath who are not having things as per their desire, they get easily frustrated, and out of that they plan to murder or they plan to commit a crime in a very brutal manner, and they do so. So they are having a very low frustration tolerance. Next characteristic is a persistent violation of social norms. As I said in previously only, that they are a type of antisocial personality disorder. That means they are having the tendency of violating everything which is a social norms. So they are having that tendency to persistently violate that particular social norms. The next characteristic of psychopath is glibness. Usually glibness is used for a person who are in sales, because if the person is in sale, they are having a good tendency or to convince another person, and they are talkative also, and they are having a capability to convince any other person that whatever thing they are saying is correct. And they are having ability to make other feel that the thing which is their perception is right, and we believe that their perception is right. So psychopaths are having that tendency, and that is a very important tendency, because as I said that they are very loved person in the society. So they are having a tendency of glibness, that's why they are loved by. The next characteristic is episodic relationship. Now here, episodic relationship means if the person is not stuck to a single relationship, he might be having n number of relationship because he fails to maintain one relationship. So they are having a tendency to have a number of relationship, and out of that relationship only they used to target people and commit crime. The last characteristic of psychopath is a need of stimulation and criminal versatility. That means psychopaths are always having an urge to commit a crime. They cannot sit after committing only one crime. They used to commit one after another. Like if you read about psychopath, and if you study psychopath like a very infamous Ted Bundy or Gacy or Elizabeth Bathory or Jack the Ripper, and even Surendra Kohli, which I think he is also psychopath, you will come to know that they used to commit a crime one after another. So they are always having an urge to commit a crime. So that is a very important characteristic of a psychopath. So this is all about who are psychopaths. Basically, in this particular video, we have discussed who are psychopaths and what are the characteristics of psychopaths. And in next video, I'm going to discuss the differences between the psychopath and sociopath. So stay tuned. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel for further videos. You may also follow us on various social media platforms by the name of Law College U. On Instagram, Law College U, Facebook, Law College U, Twitter, Law College U, LinkedIn, Law College U, and we are also having our website, that is priyasepaha.com. In that website, we used to share videos, lectures, notes, law notes basically, articles, blog, case studies, and news. I have written a book on psychopath behavior, A Need for Therapeutic Approach, which is published by Thomson & Reuters. You can get that book from Amazon also and from any reputed law store also. So link will in the description box, so you can purchase that book so that you can have a good and extensive study on psychopath behavior. So that is all for today. See you soon. Bye-bye.